Hey guys, I'm back, and this tutorial is to show you how to open up and manage and run your own VPS server. VPS server, that is basically a cloud computer. You can access it from anywhere. You can run a server on it, a Minecraft server, a Pokemon Showdown server, for example. I'm actually going to do a tutorial on that later. I might actually get to the Minecraft as well. And you can also, this morning, I just realized you can run a Shoutcast server, and that's basically an online DJ. Like you can have your online radio station for people to go listen to for whatever reason. So show you, it's pretty simple, it's free. Now this is basically a basic server. I don't think you don't for a paid server, you're gonna definitely gonna get advantages because you're gonna have a better server and more bandwidth. But I'm just gonna show you the basics on how to get a free server and how to open and manage and connect to it for the first time and how to just mess around with it. Okay. All right, so first you're going to do is you're going to go to Google and do Amazon Web Services. You go there, Cloud Computing Services, click here, sign in. This is ran by Amazon, it's in Amazon.com. You can see it's a subdomain, so no tricks. Sign in, and I already signed in, but it's going to bring you to an Amazon sign-in screen, and you're just going to either make a new Amazon account or enter your Amazon information. Now, it's going to ask you to do a free trial. All you have to do is enter the free trial, and they're going to ask for a credit card number and or a debit card. Just get a prepaid debit card if you feel insecure about it. It's Amazon. But once you get that web card, I mean the debit card, just enter it and you'll start your free trial. I believe it runs for a year. So after you get all that set up, you should come to here. Amazon Web Services. Now you see this compute section right here. You're going to see EC2. Go there. I already have a one instance running. Okay, launch instance. It's really easy to set up as by the way. Now you have Linux. You can either go by Amazon's Linux, Red Hat. Make sure you check off this free tier just to make sure you're only seeing the free ones. Ubuntu. And I'm gonna go with Windows. I'm gonna go with 2012. Click select. Okay, general purpose. See how this is the only one that has free tier. That means it won't cost me anything. Review. And go through all this, and you're going to click launch. You can create a new key pair. I'm just gonna call it tutorial. Download the key pair. Make sure you put this somewhere where you'd want it to be, like on your desktop. Put it on your desktop right here. Drag it over. And you should see it right here. Tutorial.pem. Okay. So all you're going to do now is launch instances. And your instances are now launching. You can go back, view instances. And this one that says pending, that's the one I'm working on right now. As you can see, it says tutorial. Now this right here is my Pokemon Showdown server. I'm gonna do a tutorial on that later, but I do have it running. Just a preview, I can access it. See, works just as good. Ignore all that. So whenever this comes back, I'm gonna unpause the video. It's going to take 4 minutes because if you click on it, right click, get password. Password not available yet. Wait 4 minutes. So be back in 4 minutes to show the password. Okay, let's see if it's ready to go. So I'm going to right click, get password, and key pair path. You're going to browse. I'll put it on my desktop, see tutorial.pem. Double click that. Click decrypt password, and this is the password for the server. If anyone's complaining why I put the password, I'm going to terminate or delete the server right after. So I'm just going to copy it, close, right click it again, connect, download the remote desktop file. Now you can put this file on your desktop or anywhere just for quick access. This is so you can access it without having to go through Amazon all over again. So you're just going to click it. Do not ask me again. Connect. Ask for an administrator, just paste the password. Remember your credentials? Well, if you plan on changing the password, don't check this just yet. Click OK. Okay, yes. Waiting. And in seconds. See, this looks basically just like Windows 8. It's just a server running from the cloud, so this isn't really your computer, but it is your computer in some way. Don't ask. Been showing this yet. Okay. Please wait. Now, this is normally for the first log on. Any log on after that should be pretty quick. Okay. So my desktop should be coming up pretty soon. This is my VPS cloud desktop. First thing you're gonna want to do, it depends on what you're running, but if you're using this for more casual purposes, I would go to the server manager. And this is different if you decide to get Windows 2008 or Linux or something like that. But for 2012, you're gonna go to local server, IE enhanced security configuration, click the on, and then change this to off. And because basically, Internet Explorer, if you keep Internet Explorer, it's going to keep bugging you, saying that the website's blocked or whatever. Do you want to add an exception? And it just gets pretty aggravating over time. So just going to keep it off. Or unless you download another browser for it, it's pretty good. I mean, it depends how secure you like your system, your internet. So now that that's off, you're going to go to, see, just like internet, just like Windows 8, Internet Explorer. And this is a basic system. See how it says not enabled? This is a basic system. It really only has, I believe, to look at the specs. This is just for the free system. Now, if you pay for it, of course, you're going to get good old top of the line system. That's probably better than your home PC. Going to properties, only has 1 gig of RAM, a decent processor, 64-bit. Just see, this is it's a server. Okay. One thing I really liked about this is if you want speed browsing or whatever, you go to speedtest.net. If you have something that's really slow, I would suggest going to speed, going on your VPS and trying this. Oh, okay, I'm gonna download Chrome just to show that this has a real fast internet and it is really easy, really just like Windows. Not only that, whenever I was running my Showdown server, it was. It took a computer that needed to be on 24/7 to run it. And I wasn't going to leave my computer on 24/7. I think I wasn't going to let other people connect to my network at any time. So, okay, it's going to download. And if you have a decent internet, you know this is pretty fast for downloading Chrome. So, back to Pokemon Showdown. Like, okay, this is basically a computer that's going to stay on 24/7. It already has a static IP. So all you need to do is, I'll just get to the rest of it whenever I do my Showdown tutorial. Stick to the basics here. And then it's installing, and this could take a while. It's going to take a lot longer than what's going to take to download. So I'm going to pause it and unpause it whenever Chrome finishes. Okay, Chrome is now ready. So I'm gonna go to the speed test, speedtest.net, and this is Google Fiber internet in my opinion. It's pretty. I know this isn't even close to Google Fiber. Google Fiber, I believe, is 1 gigabit per second. This, it's just unbelievable how fast this really is. Watch. Okay, your ping. Decent. Look at that download speed. That's. And I, last time this happened, I actually crashed it. I believe the speed went so fast. Look at this speed. I mean, wow. 207. That's. Isn't that like 27 megabytes a second? upload is just ridiculous. I wish I could play PS4 on this. This isn't really fast. I mean, I wish I could just take this internet. There's one thing why I love it. It's so fast. Like, the upload's even faster than a download. Okay. How's, I could just see how, no, they don't say anything. All you need to know, that's some really fast internet. But it's on a half decent computer, but the internet's really fast. So, really, that's it. It's all set up. Do whatever you wish to do on it. Minecraft, Pokemon, DJ, whatever. You are. It's in the cloud, as the movie once said. Once it's in the cloud, it's always in the cloud. I don't know how true that is, because you can just shut down the server and everything will be erased. But really, this is free now. Whether or not you should get a paid server, that goes on how much demand you need. For example, do you plan on taking, like, this free server? I believe can handle 50 users at once. So if you plan on having more than 50 users at once, I would pay about $5 a month and pay to where you can hold about 250 a month. Now, I heard from Pokemon Showdown, the creator of it, he said they pay a good bit of money every month to handle 10,000 users. I'm just going to throw a number out there that I believe he said, I think 2,000 a month. So yeah, that's a lot of, it's a lot of money for a busy server. So it all depends on, again, how popular you are. My Pokemon Showdown server is really just going to be me, probably some fans, and my friends. So it's going to stay hopefully under 50 users. Well, I mean, no harm done if it goes over 50. I'll just have to open up another. Well, this concludes my tutorial. Any questions, feel free to leave a comment. This guy had questions with the open MRS. I did the best I can to do it. I believe I fixed this problem. So hope you enjoyed it. I hope you get your server up. Best of luck for that. And subscribe for more and like this video. I know it was pretty, kept it as simple as I can. Because I just seen that this is a need on YouTube, because I'm going to continue on to the Pokemon Showdown, which is going to be pretty interesting. Hope you watch that as well. Well, thanks for watching. Once again, subscribe, like, comment, whatever you want to say to me, whatever, as long as it's not mean. Be nice. Okay, see you later.